Hey guys, Papa Matt here from traditionalconjure.com, and today I'm going to be showing you guys how to set up a table to work with, say, an Expedite. Now, in the past few days, I've had a couple of different people come to me and ask me if I'd be willing to make a video for this, and I agreed, and I actually did make a video for it, posted it online, gave out the link, and then I watched the video and come to realize that on some of the things, I could have been more detailed or given it a little bit more information or just left things out, and I apologize for the inconvenience. So the next morning I took the video down and now I'm doing a remake of it. So what do we know about St. Expedite? Well, just like his name says, he expedites things. He moves things forward. He makes them happen quickly. So St. Expedite's petition when you're in urgent need of something, and he ends procrastination and he works wonders and he does it very quickly. One thing that I've noticed is in New Orleans, they actually call St. Expedite St. Expedite. This is more than likely just because of the Creole language or what have you, but his name properly is St. Expedite, St. Expeditus. Okay, so also another thing that a couple other key points I want to cover with you guys before we begin is, one, when you petition St. Expedite, you don't bring him his offerings until he comes through for you. Once he comes through for you, however, you will bring him his offerings as quickly as you can. Now, the reason behind these things is that it's a working relationship. It's an agreement. He does something for you, you do something for him. So if you are to bring him his offerings before he comes through for you, that's kind of like telling him, okay, job well done, you completed the task, you can stop now. And so what do you think is going to happen? He's going to stop working on that case. The reason behind bringing him his offerings as soon as he comes through for you, St. Expedite will take things away just as quickly as he brings them. So that's very important to remember. I had someone ask me, well, I have an urgent financial need. Can I use green candles instead of the traditional red for St. Expedite? Yes, you can. And I've done it with great success before. I went straight too far from the colors. The typical colors for St. Expedite are green, gold, and red. Red being the more traditional, then gold, and then green. And I've worked with all three of those colors when petitioning St. Expedite, and I've had great success with each one of them. So yes, you can do that. Another question that came up is about the offerings. Now, there's a lot of people that say that St. Expedite only likes Sara Lee pound cake. Okay, that's not true. St. Expedite was around long before Sara Lee pound cake was ever thought of. But his offerings are pound cake. Some people will tell you that he also likes nickels. Now, the thing about giving nickels as an offering to St. Expedite, that's more focused on, it's a regional thing. Okay, I was taught to give him pennies, and he seems to like them just fine, but if you want to use nickels, that's fine. So his offerings, pound cake, nickels or pennies, a candle, red flowers, and a public thank you. Okay, don't forget those, the five important things, okay? Well, and also you should keep a glass of water next to him at all times as well. So now that we have the gist of all of that stuff out of the way, and I'll even go through with you how to give him his offerings and everything at the end of this video. So now on the image of St. Expedite, I work with a prayer card, okay? Because I work with St. Expedite quite a lot. So what I do is I frame his prayer card with a red cloth background. You can even see some of the cloth actually sticks out of the picture frame. But so I keep it in a frame. Now, you don't have to have a prayer card. If you can get a candle with St. Expedite's image on it, that'll work fine. You can print off an image of St. Expedite from the internet, things of that nature. Now, if you just have to have a prayer card and you can't find a Catholic bookstore that has them, print off a picture of St. Expedite, run to Walmart or a local retail store or an office supply store, and you can actually get the self-laminating packages. So then you can just put the picture in there and close it up, and you have yourself a prayer card. So on the image of St. Expedite, he stands on a crow that has a banner in its mouth. The banner in Latin says cross. What this means is tomorrow. He has a cross in his hand with the word in Latin, hodie. Hodie means today. So he's crushing tomorrow and replacing it with today. So you can see, even in his imagery, you can see why he's associated with bringing things to the forefront, bringing them to fruition, ending procrastination and things of this nature. Now, another thing that I want to tell you guys is whenever you work with St. Expedite, give him a time frame. I've heard numerous accounts of people say, oh, well, I've been working with St. Expedite to bring me this or bring me that, and it's been months and I haven't seen any results. You have to be specific. And well, you should be, not only with St. Expedite, but with any spirits or saints or whatever that you work with, you should be specific. You should be detailed. So let's say that your rent is due in 7 days, and that's what you're petitioning St. Expedite for. So then you come to St. Expedite, and you would be so specific as to say, St. Expedite, I need this $680 for my rent, and I need it before 7 days is up. I need it within 6 days, St. Expedite. 6 days. You do this for me within the next 6 days. You bring me this $680 to pay my rent within the next 6 days, and I'll bring you everything I promised you. Now, a little bit of background on St. Expedite, and this will tie into the reason why you should be specific with him. St. Expedite was martyred by being beheaded. St. Expedite, for that reason, and I haven't found any other historical reasoning behind it other than that, is that because of his beheading, he's, I don't want to say dim-witted, but he's a little bit slow. He gets things done quickly, and he's very powerful when he does them. But you have to be detailed. He's not the best at interpreting, you know, a generalized situation, so to speak. I hope that makes sense for you guys. So anyways, now that we know all of this, I'm going to show you how to set up the table. Now, everyone works differently. Everyone was taught differently. But the way that I was taught is that you'll have your image of St. Expedite to the center, or in the center, and to the back of the table. On the side of his image, where he has the crow and the cross, you will have a red candle for him. And this will be on the side and to the front. And on the opposite side, you'll have a glass of water for him. This will also be to the front. So you'll be making a triangle shape. Okay? When you write out your petition and you come to him every day, the petition will sit in front of him. And I'll give you guys a prayer to St. Expedite in the description below. And what you'll do is you'll come to St. Expedite and you'll say this prayer. You'll state your petition, and then you'll sit with him for, you know, 5-10 minutes, whatever you feel it would be good to create that bond between you and this saint. And then once you're done with the formal prayer, stating your petition and sitting with him for a few moments, you'll put the petition under the candle. OK? Okay. Now, when you come to his image and you state this prayer, or you recite this prayer and you state your petition, before you begin the prayer, you'll light the candle. Okay. And then you'll go through the formal prayer, your petition, sit with him for a few moments, and put the candle on top of the petition. Now, you'll continue doing this every single day. The lighting of the candle, reciting of the formal prayer, stating your petition, and sitting with him. You'll do this every single day until you notice a change, or until he comes through for you. So, having said that, the next thing that you're going to want to do is, when he does come through for you, I make him pound cake. I bake it myself. I don't go out and buy store-bought. It's just how I do it. But you'll take your pound cake, you'll place it on a plate, and you'll set it in front of the image of Saint Expedite. You'll tell him thank you, pray to him, sit with him for a few moments, etc. Now, the things that you'll also bring him to one side of his image, you'll have a vase or a container with red roses or yellow roses. Your pound cake in the center and before the image of St. Expedite. On top of the pound cake, you'll either take 3 or 5 pennies or nickels. What I do is I use 3 pennies. And what I'll do is I'll make a triangle on top of the pound cake. I'll stick the pennies right side up in the pound cake to form a triangle. And then I'll take a red taper and I'll stick it in the center of that pound cake. I'll light it and I'll tell him that this is in thanks to him and I'm bringing him his offerings for coming through for me. Then you'll also need to give him a public thank you. Now, you can either purchase an ad in the newspaper, put it on a website, social network, just spread his name. You want to spread his name so it'll be invoked again and again. As far as the offering with the pound cake, once the candle is burned down, you allow the pound cake to sit there. I usually don't let it sit there for any longer than 24 hours. I've had some people ask me, well, what do I do with the pound cake when, you know, the offering is done? Can I eat it? No, you don't eat it yourself. And don't throw it away either. What I do is I take the pound cake, I'll take it outside, I'll crumble it up, and I'll give it to the birds, and they'll carry off the thank you to St. Expedite. The other stuff, the pennies, the flowers, candle wax, petition, everyone does different things with their with the remains of their workings. So I'm sure you can come up with something that you'd want to do with it. Me personally, I wrap everything up. Oh, well, I don't wrap it up. I gather it up and I'll take it to a crossroads, or I'll take it and set it underneath a tree. I'll tell St. Expedite thank you again, and I'll turn my back and I'll walk away and I won't look back. And that's pretty much how you work with St. Expedite. There are varying different ways to work with him, and there's numerous prayers. So, I can't go through every single one of them, but I'll post the one that I use in the description below. Just keep in mind that triangle formation on the table, what kind of offerings he likes, bring them to him quickly when he comes through for you. Don't give them to him if he doesn't come through for you or before he comes through for you. And yes, you can use green, gold, and red candles. Also, another thing that I like to do is on my red votives, I make my own votives. So what I'll do is whenever I'm making the mix, I'll throw in a little bit of my homemade fast luck oil into the mix when I'm making it. And that'll be the candle for St. Expedite. Some people also, whenever they're setting up this triangle setup, they'll tell you that that the water actually needs to be on the right hand side of San Expedite. I'm not sure where this teaching or tradition comes from. That's not how I was taught, so that's just not how I do it. I'm not saying that it's wrong. I'm just saying this is how I was taught, and so this is really all that I can show you is you know how I was shown to do it. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope it was informative and detailed enough for you guys. And if I wasn't thorough enough, or if you guys want a little bit more information about St. Expedite or whatnot, just give me a holler. You can find me online, I'm sure. I'm all over Facebook, website. You can find me, trust me. So anyways, I'm going to leave some links right there for you guys to check out. And let's see, did I cover everything else? I think I pretty much got it all. So, yeah, I'll see you guys next time. Have a good day.